In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Life is easy when you're up on the mountain. You've got peace of mind like you've never known. But things change when you're down in the...
For our Goodnight message on this Friday, the 17th of June, 2022, broadcasting from the Salesian Pontifical University, Roma, Italy, by your servant, Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco, we listen to this inspiring and strengthening message entitled, Rejoicing While the World Falls Apart. The Bible tells us in Philippians chapter 3, verse 1, finally, my brothers, rejoice in the Lord. Paul speaks like this not because the Philippian community was having it rosy. No, they had their own troubles, but Paul encouraged them to rejoice in the Lord. The last 2 years have been, to say the least, a bit much. A global pandemic cut short millions of lives and wrought innumerable other hardships whose scope and damage we cannot yet quantify. I still recall a number of priests that we worked with on daily bread who had their lives cut short because of COVID. We have other issues that we are facing today, a European war that has featured unspeakable atrocities, displaced millions that I keep encountering here in Rome, a number of those innocent people from Ukraine, and set the world on edge with a looming threat that it could spiral into something far worse. These are just the issues that have affected everyone. They don't count the suffering and difficulty we each face at a personal level, multiplied 7 billion times over. So when we come to a verse like Philippians chapter 3 verse 1, it can understandably ring hollow. How can one rejoice when the world seems to be falling apart? The Christians at Philippi who received this exhortation lived under similar world falling apart circumstances. The imprisonment of the Apostle Paul, author of this letter and founder of the Philippian church, and many others. A Roman Empire growing more tyrannical and beginning to see this new Christian movement as a threat. A religious tradition, Judaism, out of which this new movement had arisen, that resented and sought to destroy it and its devotees. A cultural setting rife with idolatry, promiscuity, and barbarism. When these words were penned roughly 30 years after Christ's earthly life, the Christian church was going through trouble. The members of this church didn't have the hindsight of history, the possibility that their movement would be stamped out, and the dread and despair that would accompany such a danger would have been powerful and real. Paul writes, "Rejoice in the Lord." He gives us a glimpse in chapter 3, verse 10 and 11. That I may know him and the power of his resurrection, and may share his sufferings, becoming like him in his death, that by any means possible I may attain the resurrection of the dead. Christ's resurrection changed the game. Suffering, particularly persecution, meant deeper identification with Christ, an opportunity to know him more closely. Imprisonment or any setback, Paul or any believer might endure, would only result in advancing the gospel. Philippians chapter 1 verse 12. Even death itself would only be a shortcut to the glorious presence of Christ and our future resurrection, all sources of unspeakable joy. The resurrection of Christ was proof that Christianity would endure. Death would be turned to life, and that God was powerful and loving enough to turn any evil into good. This is still true today. So we can stare in the face of dire world circumstances, whatever hardships and stresses that may be burdening you today. Understand this. God is in control, and He will turn that into something good, into something joyful. So keep rejoicing, and let these hardships not veil the joy that is in the resurrection. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Good night, as it dreams.
Same to you, Father.
For the God on the mountain is still God in the valley. When things go wrong, He'll make them right. And the God of the good times is still God in the bad times. The God of the day is still